2008 was a great year for movies. Movies like Iron Man, Dark Knight, WALL-E, Cloverfield, Speed Racer, Incredible Hulk, Hellboy 2, Kung Fu Panda, Bolt, Rambo, The Mummy, Tomb of the Dragon Emperor, and Jack Brooks movie Monsters. So here's to the movies of 2008.
Basement lounge. 2008 has been quite a year, hasn't it?
To the point where we've saved ticket stubs to movies. It's been pretty incredible Hulk.
So let's talk about some trends in 2008. It seems like this was the year of the superhero movie.
We had, say, Iron Man, Incredible Hulk. What else? I know there's been more. Oh, please don't do this to me.
Dark Knight. Batman?
I don't know if anybody saw that though. Dark Knight's like, it was Batman and it was...
Yeah, Joker. I don't know if you saw it, it was kind of indie. There was also some movies based on some of your childhood memories. Speed Racer? It was a great movie.
It was fan-freaking-tastic.
More colorful than...
There are also some comic book to movie movies, like...
The Spirit. I heard it was okay.
I heard it was not okay. I heard it sucked. We didn't see it, so I can't really say anything.
So we can't really review it. But,
you know.
We heard. It was okay at best.
We also had Hellboy 2. And Punisher just came out. I haven't heard anything about it yet.
We haven't seen it.
So, we should probably get on that, since that's like our job.
To bring the reviews to you, so you don't have to go see these movies. Overall, just being honest, 2008 wasn't that great.
We decided that it wasn't.
But that doesn't mean that we didn't enjoy ourselves.
There were some. That were good. Like this one.
This one.
And there's this one.
That one was good too.
Did you see that one? That one was really good.
So, there were a few things that we did enjoy from 2008, but overall, there's been better years. I don't know if we can really blame the directors for this in all cases, but I'm gonna go ahead and do it anyway. The writing in some of these movies...
See, but they could have fixed that.
Yeah, see, as...
Quarantine?
If you were the director, you're sitting there, behind the camera, and you hear this script going on, you don't step in and say something?
Damn!
Back up. That is ridiculous.
That's a line from Quarantine, by the way.
script writing.
What else was bad?
It just seemed like there was a lot of action movies. There was a whole lot of action and glitz and
There was no good. I think WALL-E had better writing than some of the movies.
People just get a little too hung up on the action sequences and not so much on the story. We need better stories.
We need a mix of both. We need the actual good action and good writing. Like The Fall.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So things we have to look forward to in 2009 now that it's 2009. We have to look forward to Watchmen. Which, if you haven't read it, please do.
Because it's so good.
It's really good. Really good. And so far what I've seen, I think they're going to do a really good job with the movie.
Yeah, it looks really, really good. I'm very excited about it.
Yeah, it's going to be good stuff. We also have to look forward to...
Underworld?
They're coming out with a... What happened before Underworld? It's called Underworld Lichens or some. They're also coming out with Dragon Ball Z.
Action League Now?
Action League Now?
Potentially. A Donnie Darko sequel.
It's called S. Darko.
It's about his little sister. You know, the minor character that nobody cared about at all, except when she was in Sparkle Motion. supposedly, she won 3. Or The Grudge 3, I still don't know. IMDb keeps lying to me.
So if you haven't heard, there's another movie coming out. It's called The Unborn. It's a horror flick. I actually think it looks really good.
It looks pretty good.
It looks like, when we went to go see Quarantine, which is our first review that we've ever done after that.
Which you should watch.
That was one of the previews, and the previews then, we were both like back in our seats like, whoa, man.
Ooh. Do you know what I'm pretty sure is coming out in 2009? The remake of, drumroll, A Tale of Two Sisters.
Oh. So here's the 2008. Goodbye.
Should all acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should all acquaintance be forgot and days of auld lang syne? For auld lang syne, my joy.
Everybody to know, because I know everybody was wondering. I know you guys are fans. This, in case you were wondering, because I know you were, like I said, this fantastic shirt that I'm wearing underneath is, yes, in fact, Sailor Moon. It is a, just as you can see, an absolutely fantastic shirt made by a woman by the name of Mackenzie Borski. She made the shirt for me for my birthday, and I will cherish it forever. She also just made me one for Christmas of the fall, and I will be wearing that in a later review. So stay tuned.